Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn new topic, some applications of trigonometry. In this topic, we are going to learn or we are going to discuss the examples regarding the height and distance by using the basics, means by using the trigonometric ratios. So here, the terms which are related to this topic, some applications of trigonometry are line of sight, angle of elevation and angle of depression. So first we will see what is angle of elevation, what is angle of depression and line of sight. Okay, so here suppose the one person is standing here. Okay, then he will see exactly to the front side. If I am standing here, I will see first here in front of, right? So I will see exactly to the horizontal line. Okay, so from here, so this is the horizontal line. Okay, so this is the observer, this is our observer at point O, and this OX is the horizontal line. Then an object is placed at this point P. Then observer have to see this object which is under consideration at point P, then how much degree eye movement he has to do to see this point. Okay, our object is here at point P, then to see this object at point P, how much degree angle we have to make the movement of your eyes. So that is called the angle of elevation. Okay, so from here, this XOP is called the angle of elevation. Okay, so this is angle of elevation. Okay, so and the angle of elevation is denoted by theta. Then this OP is called line of sight. Line of sight. So what is the line of sight? Line of sight is the line is what? The line from the eyes of the observer to the object where we have placed, that is called the line of sight. Okay, similarly, what is the angle of depression? Suppose the observer is here at point P, right? And this is supposed to be X. So P is horizontal line, this is, and observer is at point P. Your object is under consideration at point O, for example. Observer is at point P and object is under consideration at point O. Then how much degree, means first this observer will see to the front, means into the horizontal way, how much degree angle in which, how much degree angle he has to make this eye movement. So it is called the angle of depression. Angle of depression. Okay, so this theta is called angle of depression, and this is your line of sight. So object is at point O. So XPO, angle, or angle XPO is called the angle of depression, right? Now we will see the examples. A tower is 100 root 3 meter high. Find the angle of elevation of its top from the point 100 meter away from its foot. Okay, so here this tower AB is the tower. Then what is the height of the tower? 100 root 3. So H equals to 100 root 3 meters. Find the angle of elevation of its top from the point 100 meter away from its distance. So here one of the point which is 100 meter away from its, so it is 100 meter and we have to find the angle of elevation. So means your observer is here and the object is here. Object means here, object is what? Top of the tower. Observer has to see the top of the tower. So how much degree angle he has to make the movement. So that is the angle of elevation we have to find out. Okay, so theta we have to find. Now this is the ground level and this is the tower. So they are perpendicular to each other. Correct. Now we have to find the theta to see or to find the theta. So what is the ratio related to the adjacent side and opposite side? We will give here the point C is the 100 meter away from the foot of the tower. Let AB be the height of tower, that is H equals to 100 root 3 meter. Then BC equals to 100 meter. Then we have to find the angle of elevation. So angle ACB, or we have to find the angle of elevation. So that is theta equals to what, right? So here what is the ratio related to the opposite side to the adjacent side? Of course tan relation. So tan theta equals to AB by BC. So AB is what? 100 meter, 100 root 3, and BC is what? 100 tan theta. So 100, 100 get cancelled. So you will get tan theta equals to root 3. So which tan theta having the root 3 is ratio? 60 degree equals to root 3. So your theta equals to 60 degree. So what is the angle of elevation? Angle of elevation is 60 degree. Understood? Now we will see the next example. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a point on a ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. Find the height of the tower. Okay, so here this is tower. Okay, this is foot of tower and this is your top of the tower. Okay, and this is the ground level. Then the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a point on the ground. So suppose this point P is on the ground. Okay, from the point which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. So point P is 30 meter away from this foot of the tower. So this distance is 30 meter. Okay, so we'll take this Q and this point is R. So RQ is the tower. And what is the height of the tower? We have to find the height of the tower. And angle of elevation is how much given? Is 30 degree, right? Angle of elevation from this point to the top of the tower is 30 degree. So we have to find the height of the tower. Okay, so let RQ be the height of tower. Then angle of elevation is given, theta equals to what given? 30 degree, that is the angle of elevation. Then PQ, that point P is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. So that the distance is PQ equals to 30 meter. Okay, now here we have to find the RQ. So what is the ratio related to the opposite side and adjacent side of the theta? Of course tan 30 degree. So we will find in triangle RQP, this is always 90 degree. So in triangle RQP, tan theta equals to RQ by PQ, correct? So tan theta is how much? Tan 30 degree equals to RQ that we have to find, and PQ is 30 meter. Okay, so what is the tan 30 degree value? Tan 30 degree equals to 1 by root 3. So we will put here 1 by root 3 equals to RQ by 30. Okay, so root 3 RQ equals to 30. So RQ equals to 30 by root 3. Now rationalize this denominator. So root 3 by root 3. So 30 root 3 upon 3. So 3 tens are 30. So you will get 10 root 3. So height of the tower equals to 10 root 3 meters. Okay. Now we will see next example. Observer is 1.5 meter tall, is 28.5 meter away from the tower. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from her eyes is 45 degree. What is the height of the tower? Okay, so tower, then this is the ground level. Okay, now here observer is 1.5 meter tall, means here one observer is standing here. The height of the observer is 1.5 meter. So of course the eyes from where she can see the top of the tower. So here observer's eyes. So height of the observer is 1.5 meter. So if you will draw from this horizontal line, then this distance is also 1.5 meter, correct? Now this is the total height of tower H, then that we have to find. So we will take this point A, B, C, D and E. Okay, so A is the height of the tower. Observer is stand here, then he will see, she will see from this point to the top of the tower. So angle movement of her eyes will from here. So angle of elevation from her eyes is 45 degrees. So from here angle of elevation is 45 degrees. Distance is 28.5 meters. So of course this horizontal and this the parallel distance between these two lines. So this 1.5, and if this 1.5, this 1.5, so this horizontal distance is exactly equals to each other. So this is also 28.5 meter. Okay, so in this example first we have to find the AB, and when you will get AB, so height of the total height of the tower equals to AB plus BE. Okay, so here let AE be the height of tower. Okay, that is AE equals to AB plus BE. Okay, then here this is height of the tower. Then BC is equals to BC equals to ED is equals to 28.5 meter. Then height of the observer, height of observer CD equals to 1.5 meter, and the theta angle of elevation is 45 degree. Okay, so if we have to find this AB, then what is the ratio related to the opposite and adjacent tan theta ratio, right? So in triangle ABC, ABC this is perpendicular distance. Okay, so in triangle ABC tan 45 degree equals to AB by BC. So what is the value of tan 45? Tan 45 is always 1. Okay, so 1 equals to AB is not given, that we have to find. BC is 28.5. okay, so you will get AB equals to 28.5 meter. Finally, we have to find a total distance or total height of the tower. So, the height of tower is equals to AB plus BE. Okay, so what is AB? We got 28.5 plus B is 1.5. Okay, then it will get 30 meters. Okay, so height of the tower equals to 30 meters. Understood? Now we will see next example. Okay, next example. A kite is flying at a height of 60 meters above the ground. The string attached to the kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground. The inclination of the string with the ground is 60 degree. Find the length of the string assuming that there is a no slack in the string. Okay, so suppose this is the point where point A, that there is your kite. Okay, so kite is 60 meter above the ground. So from this ground to point A, where there is a kite, so it is the 60 meter. Okay, then the string is attached to kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground. So suppose on the ground, this is your ground, the point is C. So AC is the string attached to the kite and tied to the point C on the ground. Okay, then the inclination of the string with the ground, so this AC, the inclination with the AC to the ground is 60 degree. So this is the angle of elevation here. It is 60 degree. We have to find the length of the string assuming that there is a no slacks in the string. Okay, so here then we have to find the length of the string, right? So now length of the string means this 90 degree. So this is right angle triangle. Here this hypotenuse. So ratio related to the opposite side to the hypotenuse. So of course it is sine ratio. So here first we write, let this be, let A be a kite and AC is the string which attached to the ground attached to the point C on the ground. Okay, and the inclination of the string with the ground, the inclination of the string to the ground is 60 degree. Okay, so ratio related to the opposite side to the, we have to find the length of the string, that is the hypotenuse. So it is sine ratio, right? So sine theta. So first we will write, so here in triangle ABC, sine theta equals to AB by AC. Okay, sine 30, sine 60 degree equals to AB. AB is what? 60 given, and AC, that we have to find. What is the ratio, or what is the value of sine 60 degree? So root 3 by 2. Okay, so root 3 by 2 equals to 60 upon AC. So you will get root 3 into AC equals to 60 multiplied by 2. So AC equals to 60 multiplied by 2 upon root 3. So we will rationalize the denominator. So root 3 by root 3. So you will get 60 2s are 120
root 3 upon 3. 3, 4 is 12, 3 0 0. So 40 root 3, and this is the what length of the string that we have to find. So AC equals to length of the string is equals to 40 root 3 meters. Okay, now we'll see next example. Now next example, an electrician has to repair an electric fault on a pole of height 4 meter. He needs to reach a point of 1.3 meter below the top of the pole to undertake the repairing work. What should be the length of the ladder that he should use when inclined at the angle of 60 degree to the horizontal would enable to him reach the required position. Okay, so this is the electrician pole, electric pole. So AB is the electric pole of total height is 4 meter. Then electrician has to repair an electric fault on the top of the pole of height is 4 meter. So here electric fault is there. So electrician has to repair this work. So he needs to reach a point which is 1.3 meter below. So he will wait here. So that distance is this point is C, where the electrician has to reach to repair this electric fault. So that distance is 1.3 meter, correct? To undertake this repairing work, what should be the length of the ladder that he should be used to incline at the angle of 60 degree to the horizontal? So he will use to go there, this point as point C. So he will use this ladder which inclined 60 degree angle to the horizontal. Okay, so this is the 60 degree angle. Now we have to find this BC, and then by using which ratio opposite side to the hypotenuse. So what is the ratio related to these two sides? Of course, which is sine ratio, correct? So here let AB be the height of pole, okay, equals to 4 meter. Then AC or point C, where the electrician has to reach to undertake the repairing work. Okay, so here AC equals to 1.3 meter. Then we will find out BC. So BC equals to AB minus AC. So what is AB? 4 minus 1.3. Okay, so 4 minus 1.3. So you will get here, after subtraction, you will get 2.7 meter, right? So this distance is 2.7 meter, correct? Now we have to find here the ratio related to the hypotenuse and opposite side. So sine 60 degree equals to C by CD, okay? BC by CD. So what is the sine theta? Theta is 60 degree. So sine 60 degree equals to BC. BC is what? 2.7 upon ACD we have to find out. Okay. So what is the value of sine 60 degree? Sine 60 degree equals to root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 equals to 2.7 by CD. Right? So root 3 multiplied by CD equals to 2.7 multiplied by 2. So CD equals to 2.7 multiplied by 2 by root 3. Okay. So CD equals to 2.7 multiplied by 2 by root 3. So here we will rationalize the denominator. 7 2s are 54, means this 5.4 here. Root 3 upon root 3 into root 3, 3 you will get, right? So 3 1s are 3 and 2 remaining, 3 8s are 24. So 1.8 root 3 meter, or we can write this 1.8 means what? 18 by 10 root 3. So 2 5s are 10 and 2 9s are 18. So 9 by 5 root 3 meters. So this is the length of the ladder that we have to find. Okay, we have to find length of the ladder. Understood? Now we will see the next example. Next example, from a point on the ground 40 meter away from the foot of the tower. So this is tower. Okay. AB is the tower. From a point on the ground 40 meter away from the foot of the tower. So here one point is there. Suppose this point is C. So BC is 40 meter. Then the angle of elevation to the top of the tower is 30 degrees. So this is your top of the tower. So angle of elevation from this point is 30 degrees. Then the angle of elevation to the top of the water tank on the top of the tower. So water tank is here, which is on the top of the water, which is on the top of the tower. Okay. So at this point means from the here to here, this is the water tank. Okay. Then the angle of elevation of the top of the water tank is 45 degree. It means from this same point, the angle of elevation to the top of the water tank is 45 degree. So from this point C, so this is angle of elevation is 45 degree. Then we have to find the height of the tower and the depth of the water tank. So here we will take this H is the depth of the water tank and H1 is the height of your tower. Okay, so this A, B, C, and we will take this point D, right? So now here we will write, let AB equals to H1 be the height of tower. Okay, then AD equals to H be the height of water tank. Correct? Then C is the point from here, the angle of elevation to the top of the tower and top of the water tank. So that distance from the foot of the tower to this point is 40 meter. So BC equals to 40 meter, right? So here this 90 degree angle. So first we will find in triangle DBC, or we can take in triangle ABC, anyhow, right? So in triangle DBC, okay, DBC, in that which angle is there? Angle 45, right? And the ratio related to the opposite side to the adjacent side is tan ratio, right? So tan theta equals to total DB upon BC. DB upon BC. So tan, which angle is 45 degree, correct? So here DB is what? Total DB means what? H plus H1. So H plus H1 upon BC 40 meter. So what is the value of tan 45? Is 1. So 1 equals to H plus H1 by 40. So H plus H1 equals to 40. So this you got here first. Now similarly we will find in the triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, tan 30 degree equals to AB by BC. Okay, AB by BC. So what is the value of tan 30 degree? Tan 30 degree equals to 1 by root 3 equals to, what is AB? AB equals to H1 and BC is 40 meters, right? So we will find h1 equals to 40 by root 3. So rationalize this denominator, root 3 by root 3. So 40 root 3 by 3. Capital means we have to use the value of root 3 equals to 1.732. So 40 multiplied by 1.732 divided by 3. So approximately you will get here 23.1. After simplifying, you will get 23.1 meters. Okay, so this you got h1. H1 is what? Height of the tower. Okay, so here we got here h1 equals to height of tower equals to 23.1 meter. Okay, now we will find h. Okay, that is the depth of the water tank. So from this first, h plus h1 equals to 40. So h plus, what is the h1? 23.1 equals to 40. So h equals to 40 minus 23.1. So you will get h equals to 16.9 meters. So this is your depth of the water tank. Okay, depth of the water tank. Okay, understood? Now I will see next example. Next example, a person standing on the bank of the river observed that an angle subtended by a tree on the opposite bank is 60 degree. When he retreats 20 meter from the bank, he finds the angle to be 30 degree. Find the height of the tree and the breadth of the river. So this is tree, okay, then BC be the height of the tree, here AB is the width of the river. Then a person is standing on the bank of the river, observe that the angle subtended by a tree on the opposite of the bank is 60 degrees. So from here your angle is 60 degree. Okay, when he retreats 20 meter from the bank, this is the width of the river. So this at point A, when he retreats from the bank of the river, he retreats 20 meter. So this point is D. So point D is the, when he retreats from the bank of the river, that AD distance is 20 meter. He finds the angle to be 30 degree. Then from here to this point, angle is 30 degree. Find the height of the tree and the breadth of the river. So we will take this, breadth of the river is x and height of the tree h meters we will take. Okay, in this x meters, right? So here 90 degree. So first we write, let BC be the BC equals to h meters be the height of tree. Okay, then AB equals to x meter, that is width of or breadth of river, right? And AD distance is AD equals to 20 meter, and total BD equals to 20 plus x meters. Okay, now here in triangle ABC, first we take in triangle ABC, the ratio related to the opposite side to
adjacent side is tan ratio. Okay, so tan 60 degree, tan 60 degree equals to BC by AB. Okay, BC by AB. So tan, what is the tan 60 degree value? Is root 3. Okay, tan 60 degree is root 3 equals to BC is H, that we have to find, and AB equals to X. Correct? So here H equals to root 3, X we got. Correct? Now next, in triangle CBD. In triangle CBD, tan 30 degree. This ratio is a tan 30 degree is related to opposite to adjacent. So tan 30 degree equals to H upon this total distance is BD. So first we will write tan 30 degree equals to BC by BD. Okay, so tan 30 degree is what is the value of tan 30 degree? Tan 30 degree equals to 1 by root 3. Okay, so 1 by root 3 equals to what is BC? BC equals to H upon BD 20 plus X. So you will get H equals to, so here you will get H equals to 20 plus X by root 3. Right, and here H equals to root 3X. So from here this H and this H is same. For so we will equate this one first and second. So root 3X equals to 20 plus X by root 3. Now this root 3 will come to here. So you will get root 3 into root 3, 3. So 3X equals to 20 plus X. So 3X minus X, 2X equals to 20. So 2 1 that 2 10, and so X equals to 10. So X equals to 10 means you got here width of the river. So width of the river, river equals to 10 meters. Okay, now we have to find what height of the tree. Okay, so H equals to, we will find H equals to root 3 X. Okay, root 3 X. So root 3 into what is the X value? We got 10. So 10 root 3 meter. This is height of tree. Okay, equals to 10 root 3 meters. Okay, now we will see next example.
Next example, two pillars of the equal height on the either side of the road, which is the 100 meter wide. The angle of elevation of the top of the pillars are 60 degree and 30 degree. At the point on the road between the pillars, find the position of the point. Find the position of the point between the pillars and height of the pillars. So the two pillars are of the equal height on the either side of the road. So here this is your road. Okay, two pillars on the either side of the road, both having the same height. So this AB is the first one pillar and CD is second one pillar. The height is same, that is H meters. Okay, then the total distance is AC, is total distance is the road is 100 meter wide. Okay, so here one of the angle of elevation of the top of the pillars are 60 degree and 30 degree at a point on the road between the pillars. So one point, let P be the point on the road. P be the point on the road which makes air 60 degree and 30 degree
The angle of elevation of the top of the pillars are 60 degree and 30 degree at the point on the road between these pillars. So these two pillars between the and the point P is between the two pillars, and from there the top angle of elevation to the top of the two pillars are what? 60 degree and 30 degree. So from here to here 60 degree, and from this from point P to the top of the second pillar the angle of elevation is 30 degree. Now this AP distance we will take that x, so then PC will be 100 minus x. Okay, so now here let AB, let AB and CD be the two pillars on the either sides of the road having the equal height. So here AB equals to CD equals to h meters. Okay, then P is the point on the road. So P be the point on the road. Okay, between these two pillars. Then here this at point P in this triangle angle is 60 degree, and at point P in this triangle angle of elevation is 30 degree to the top of the tower. So here total distance AC equals to 100 meters. So here point P from the point A, so here AP equals to x meters and PC equals to 100 minus x meters. Okay, now we will take in triangle PAB. Okay, so in triangle PAB, what is the ratio related to the opposite side and adjacent side? Tan ratio. So tan theta equals to AB by AP. Okay, tan which degree? Tan 60 degree equals to AB equals to H and AP equals to X. Okay. So what is the value of tan 30 degree? What is the value of tan 60 degree? Tan 60 degree equals to root 3. So root 3 equals to h by x. Okay, h by x. So you will get here h equals to root 3 x. Okay, this you got first. Now in triangle, in second triangle, in triangle PCD. Okay, here also this is 90 degree. So in triangle PCD, so tan, here also tan theta equals to DC by PC. So tan theta is how much degree? 30 degree. So tan 30 degree equals to, tan 30 degree equals to, what is the DC? DC is H and PC 100 minus X. Okay, so what is the tan 30 degree value? Tan 30 degree equals to 1 by root 3. Okay, so tan 30 degree equals to 1 by root 3 equals to H upon 100 minus X. Okay, so here cross multiplication, root 3 H equals to 100 minus X. This you got second. Okay, now here H you got root 3X. So this is your second. So this first value, H value, we can replace here with this H. Okay, so H equals to root 3X, and here we will put H equals to root 3X value. So root 3 into root 3X equals to 100
minus x. So root 3 into root 3. So here 3x equals to 100 minus x. So 4x equals to 100. So you will get x equals to 25. So what is the x? X is the distance of a point P from the first pillar. Okay. So here distance or the position. Okay, we have to find the position of the point between the pillars. So this is the point P. Point P is 25 meter from first pillar. Okay. Then similarly we have to find for the second pillar. So second pillar what? 100 minus x. So 100 minus x you will get 75. So here point P is 75 meter from second pillar. Okay. Also we have to find the height of the pillar. So how we can find the height of the pillar? H equals to root 3x. Okay. So H equals to root 3x. Correct. So what is the value of x? Here 25, right? Root 3 into 25. So what is the root 3 value? 1.732 multiplied by 25. So 43.3 meters. Okay, so this is the height of two pillars is equals to 43.3 meters. Okay. Thank you.